Why America is going to hell. Why America is going to hell. They're really gonna burn me on the cross with that one. What shall I say? America, room service? Yeah. There isn't any more room service tonight, but when did that start? Last week, well, we were here last week, and y'all were serving room service all the way up to midnight. Now, I've always been able to get me a cup of coffee when I wanted it, when I needed it. I just want a coffee, one cup. Thank you. Thank you kindly. I've got some work to do tonight before I go to bed, and I... Yes, you can send it right on up. Room 306, yeah. Yes, we call it the King Abernathy Suite, too. Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate that, sir. And we thank you for your prayers. We are not going to stop. These sanitation workers are going to get their due. I am here to make sure of that. Yes, sir. My autograph, sir. I'm sorry, I don't give those out. I only give thanks. Yes, sir, thank you. It'll be right on up. 5 minutes. Thank you. Thank you kindly. America, America, my country 'tis of thee, my country who doles out constant, sweet Jesus, we ain't even started marching and I got marching feet already. My toothbrush again. Corey, pick up. Corey, pick up. Of thee, my country, who doles out constant misery, war abroad and war on your streets. Arrogant America, what shall I do? Reverend, about time, man. The store ain't but down the street.
Room service, sir.
Well, that was fast.
Well, I've been called quicker here, maybe, before.
Where are my manners? Come on in.
Where would you like me to put these?
On the table over there. How much is that going to cost?
Folks down there say it's on the house for you. It like this your house, they say. So you ain't got to pay them, but... You can pay me a tip for getting my pressing curl wet out in his rain.
You new?
First day, sir.
That's why I've never seen you before. I've stayed here plenty of times, but I've never seen your face.
And I done seen yours before, though.
Oh, have you?
Of course, on the TV down at Woolworth's. You like the Beatles.
I wish folks would listen to me like they listen to the Beatles.
Mm-hmm. Especially white folks. Sound like you need some tea, not no coffee. You got a cold?
No, I'm fine. Just done got to getting hoarse from shouting.
And carrying on.
No, not carrying on, testifying.
Shame I didn't get a chance to see you tonight. I heard you carried on a storm down at Mason Temple.
How would you know
that? Negro talk strike faster than lightning. They say folks is all crying and singing. I would like to have seen that, you know, something to tell my children. When I wasn't nothing but a chickadee, I seen Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. cutting up in the pulpit.
I wish it had been more.
I bet that was something to see.
Wish there had been more folks there.
How many was there?
Couple of thousand.
Honey, that a lot.
It could have been more, in my humble opinion.
But it was storming. Tornadoes, and I'll get out. You can't get no Negro folk out in the rain like this.
And why is that?
I'll strike you down if you move around too much. That's what my mama used to say. Now, when it stormed like this, my mom would say, be still. But I think she just wanted us cheering to sit our tails down somewhere because the lightning spooked her nerves so bad. Personally, I just think God be acting up.
Dewey, is that why you didn't come?
No. It's my first day here at work. Wanted to come in early.
Well, I don't blame you, folks. Shoot, I almost didn't come myself.
Why that?
Just ain't been feeling too good.
Oh, a little sick.
You could say that. Personally, I don't think God's what kept folks in their houses tonight. Folks just don't care.
Folks afraid of getting blown up. Churches ain't even safe for us, well. You all right?
Sure.
You need anything else before I go?
Actually, if you've got a cigarette.
Cigarettes and coffee? That ain't a diet to be fitting up a preacher.
Judge not and ye shall not be judged.
Honey, how is that? I guess if you was at home, you'd be eating more, right?
I suppose.
What you miss most that she made?
Her egg sandwiches.
I like some too. Make one every day for myself.
Not too many women running around here smoking pow mows. I'm impressed.
Quiet. My daddy smoked pow mows. Said cools will kill you.
Smoke one with me.
What?
Have one with me.
No, Preacher King. You're about to have my boss up after me. I don't know what the rules is yet. Don't know where the dark corners at in this place is to hide and smoke my pow mows. Don't even know which room to lay my head for a quick nap.
How about this one?
Last folk up in here was doing a hoochie coochie for pay. I wouldn't lay down in that bed if somebody paid me.
Well, what kind of rules does a little lady like you break?
None that involve no preacher, I'll tell you that.
Well, everybody breaks a rule every now and then.
Oh, yes, sir, I agrees with you, but not tonight. Not tonight.
Just have one with me. Now, they're not going to come looking for you.
You the one gonna get caught kidnapping me like this.
Just one, till my friend comes back with my pack.
You sure try hard at it.
Well, you're pretty.
I know. Even my uncle couldn't help himself. You have fun tonight?
Fun?
It got to be fun, otherwise you wouldn't do it.
Not much fun in this.
Sound like grand fun to me. Standing up there in the middle of them great big old churches, people clapping for you, falling out. Must be motherfucking grand to me so much as about it. You know, shit, that must be grand. Ooh, we're a needle and thread to sew up my mouth. You know, you just a cussing all up in front of you, Preacher King. I cuss worse than a sailor with a clap. God gonna get me. I'm falling straight to hell just for cussing in front of you.
No. According to your face, I believe you done fell straight from heaven.
You little pulpit poet, you. I like you.
I like you too. Excuse me.
Well, I'll just be on my...
Dr. King here. Oh, Corey, yes, I did call. You didn't pick up? Oh, you were in a meeting. Oh. Yes, it went fine. It went fine. Not a lot of people there, but it was enough. Now, you know, you forgot to pack my toothbrush again. Yep. Now, dear, you can't remember everything. Don't worry, I'll get another one in the morning. They called again, huh? What'd they say this time? ugly voices, huh? You worried? I'm not. The children asleep? Oh, she's still up. She shouldn't be up this late past midnight. Oh, she can't sleep. Well, let me talk to her. Hey, it's Pa. Mm-hmm. And what Pa say? You have to listen to your Ma when Pa's not around. That's right. Oh, you can't sleep. Me too sometimes. But you know what I do? I just lay there and pray. And before I know it, I nod right on off to sleep. It makes everything real peaceful. Mm-hmm. You promise you're gonna be good. All right. Well, let me talk to your mom. Oh, she's in the bathroom. Well, just tell Yolanda and the boys I'll see them when I get home. All right. Good night, Bernice.
You shouldn't lie like that, you know.
Like what?
About drinking tea. Lying to
you. Well, coffee can't cure no cold, can it?
Coffee with a little whiskey in it, can it? It's what the Irish call cough syrup. She's beautiful, you know, your wife. I seen on TV down at Woolworths too. Coretta Scott.
Mrs. King.
Oh yeah, Mrs. King.
The color of coffee with a lot of milk and a lot of sugar. Just how I like it.
Well, I like my coffee black and bitter.
Carrie Mae, that's not what you said earlier.
Folks shortly, call me Carrie Mae. Hmm?
Carrie Mae.
No, no, no. Carrie Mae.
That doesn't make sense.
It do too. Say it with me. Carrie Mae.
Carrie Mae.
Right, there you go. Carrie Mae.
Carrie Mae.
Carrie Mae.
Cammy.
Right. Sound good coming out your mouth.
Lots of things do.
Sure do.
Sure do.
Well, you just ask for me if you need anything else. Just pick up the phone, give me a holler, the switch room man to give me, you know.
Can I ask for you especially?
If me is what you want.
Well, all right.
All righty then.
Can I ask you a question before you go, and you promise to answer me open and honest?
Depending on what the question is.
You won't think less of me as a man if I ask.
I might.
I've been wanting a woman's opinion on this.
Like I said, depending on what the question is. Sure.
Do you think I should shave off my mustache?
Yes. I was just saying to myself just then, he looks so damn ugly with that mustache.
Really?
Somewhere up there.
What? No, I'm serious. Tell me the truth now. Mustache? No mustache. Mustache? No mustache. Mustache? No mustache.
Where's that man with your paw mouth? Because
I'm
asking me these crazy questions.
I don't know where Ralph is. I just thought I'd get a woman's opinion.
Well, have you asked your wife?
No.
Well, answer then. She the one supposed to be making them kind of decisions anyway.
I just wanted to shave some years off. I done got to looking old.
You have. You look older in person. When women get older, they get ugly. When men get older, they get handsome. Wrinkles look good on a man, especially when they got some money to go with their ring.
Women do like men with wrinkles, don't they?
I don't. I like them young and wild, like me.
Like you?
Yes, preacher guy.
I used to be young and wild myself.
You a preacher. That's part of your job requirement. How you know what you ain't supposed to do if you ain't done it yourself? Listen to you otherwise. That's what I call work experience. What to qualify you for the position.
And what qualifies you to be a maid?
I'm better at cleaning up other folks' messes than my own. I was called to do this.
Well, I think I was too. Can I have another one?
You ain't about to leave me here to work through the night with nothing to smoke on. Shit, all I got is what's spread left.
To share, of course.
I gotta say, you sure do try hard at it, huh?
Well, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Goddamn folk got you changed smoking harder than a motherfucker, huh? I'm so sorry. Preacher Kane. I just can't control my mouth. God gonna get me for that one, too.
Don't worry. I forgive you.
I'm glad somebody did.
Well, don't want to keep you. I guess you've got other folks' messes to clean up. Don't forget your umbrella.
Uh-oh, that ain't mine. That's yours. Boss wanted me to bring that up for you. Sorry, I got it wet.
Thank you kindly. April 4th, how y'all get tomorrow's paper?
Tomorrow already here.
Kane challenges court restraint, vows to march. They got that right. This mayor Loeb calls himself not allowing those sanitation workers to march over my dead body. Yesterday, two U.S. Marshals sped across town to serve Dr. King with copies of the order. They found him at the Lorraine Motel along with four other defendants.
Folks can send you flowers if they know what you're saying.
That's not all they can send me. The city says it is seeking an injunction as a means of protecting Dr. King. We are fearful that in the turmoil of the moment, someone may even seek to harm Dr. King's life. We want to use all the force of language to emphasize that we don't want that to happen. I wish this mayor had jurisdiction over airplanes too. You know, Kame, someone phoned in a bomb threat on my flight from Atlanta to Memphis. Thank God they didn't find one.
Just another day on the job, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Civil rights can't put a power
mouse with. I like your sense of humor. Morbid like mine. Woo! I thought they got me.
You all right?
Yes,
are
I
you
am.
All right?
Yes, I am. Yes.
Don't tell me a grown man like you afraid of the light.
No, that's not what I'm afraid of.
The thunder?
Yes, it sounds like...
Fireworks?
Yes, indeed it does.
Don't be scared of the fireworks. I love me some fireworks. Mama used to take us down to Tom Lee Park to see fireworks every 4th of July.
Independence Day.
That's right. Y'all bougie black folk call it Independence Day. I just can't seem to quite call it that yet.
You sure is pretty, Henry.
That's about the third time you've told me that.
The second?
The first time was with your eyes.
Mm-hmm. You saw me.
Hell, a blind man could have seen the way you was blowing holes through my clothes. Ah, you blushing?
Which is really hard for a black man to do.
Sugar hush, you just a man. Mind you, I'd be staring at me too.
Well, I guess it's your turn to forgive me.
Forgiven and forgotten.
Thanks for the square, Camille.
I got some family from Detroit, that way they call them up there.
Oh, so you've been to Detroit. How you like it?
I said I got some family from up there. I ain't never been.
Well, don't.
Why?
Negro folks up there haven't seemed to lost their mind, like to get to ride and to carry on.
Well, honey, I need to move up there then. Because these white folk down here about to be catching flies now the way they be acting with Negroes these days. You can catch the first greyhound up there. Detroit nigga heaven if you ask me.
So are you an honorary pastor?
Ram. Well, you know, walking will only get you so far.
Without walking, we're marching.
Whatever it is, it ain't working.
Well, no. It's not going to work, especially when you got trifling Negroes who call themselves using a peaceful protest to go in and break them in and give them a free color television.
Who done did that?
Well, just last week, me and my men organized a march.
Them garbage men?
The sanitation workers. Should have seen it. There must have been thousands upon thousands of people there. Thousands. Everybody from old men to teenage girls to little boys, all holding up signs that read, I am a man. I am a man. Somehow they squeezed me to the front, and the march began. I am a man. I am a man, we shouted. We hadn't walked but one block before we heard the sound of glass breaking. I was swept up into a tornado of arms and legs, coughing and mace. I did not want to leave those people, Camille. I did not want to leave them. But my men pushed me into a passing car. And I looked out that back window and saw such a blessed peace descend into utter chaos. Don't they know? You can't go marching for peace and then go break in and get you a free color television. We marching for a living wage, not a damn color TV. Just give those police an excuse to shoot innocent folk like they did with that boy, Larry Payne. Larry Payne, Larry Payne. Well, we're back. And we're going to do it right this time. So Larry Payne does not have to have died in vain. Where is that nigga with my pack?
Maybe he got stuck talking with some crazy lady in a motel room too. I'm funny. Wow!
Well, I'm worried. I don't want nothing to happen to him. Something happened upon him in the night, I don't know what I'd do.
That your best friend?
More loyal than a dog. He the one got me down to the church tonight, got me out of bed. I just ain't been feeling too well. He probably down there with my brother now. He don't like being around me, seeing I got to being so moody and such. Just forget about it, Martin, he says. Just forget about it. After the march, the papers called me Chicken a la King. Said I was a commie coward who leaves others to clean up his mess. Martin Loser King.
Seemed like time been a little rough on me.
Who are you telling? Who are you telling? Oh, this rain is relentless. Looking like a monsoon here in Memphis.
Well, God ain't gonna stop crying no time soon.
You smoke like a man.
You smoke like a fruit.
Oh, now, Camé, don't use those kind of words.
Oh, what, you root for the fruits?
Indeed, I do. All of God's children got wings.
Well, I agree with you on that one, but you just ain't smoking it right.
Well, how am I supposed to smoke it?
Like it's going out of style. Like you need it. Like you want it. That's what I smoke. Make a woman feel sexy. I bet I know why you smoke.
Why?
To look sexy.
Well, now you're making me blush.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. smoking. Ain't that something? Because I could take a picture of it.
You with the FBI?
No, something bigger. That's it. There you go. There you go, pull harder. Harder! If you want to lead the people, you gotta smile like the people. That way people listen to you.
Well, what you think, they don't listen?
They listen. They go out and they march. Then they get their pressing girls ruined by fire hoses. You know, folks just done got tired, Preacher Kane. Like I say, walking would only get us so far.
Well, killing will get you hung.
Ain't nobody said nothing about no killing. Cam May all about ass whoopings. How about a march for ass whoopings?
That's not gonna do.
Well, we need to be doing something else.
Well, what would you suggest we do?
Something else here. I've got bunions and corns for days.
You know, you Negroes always want to complain, but can only come up with something else. You're just like Andy, or better yet, Jesse. Everybody can shoot holes in your ideas, but can only come up with something else.
Well, I got a plan, but I'm just a woman. Folk can never listen to me.
Well, if you were me, what would you do?
Really? You want to know what little old me would do?
Yes.
You really want to know what I do?
Yes, I do.
Can I buy your jacket? And your shoes?
Voice that the white man will listen to. Tired of shouting and carrying on like you say. I done got hoarse. I just don't know what makes them hate us so much, Camay. I done seen white folks hate us so much. Bombing homes, shooting folk, blowing up children.
Make you scared to bring a Negro child to this world the way they blowing them up.
They hate so easily and we love too much.
You know, last time I heard you was preaching, we all the same. Negro folk, white folk, we all alike.
Well, at the most basic human level, we are all the same.
What they one thing we all got in common?
We all scared. Scared, Camay. Scared of each other and scared of ourselves. And they scared of losing something they've known for a long time. See, fear makes us all human. It's part of our basic human needs, like a smile or a hug or...
A smoke?
Which I could use one more of. Where's that nigga with my pack? Is he down there? You see him?
No.
Well, he won't be gone too long. He knows I don't like to be alone. I just wish I had another one to share, of course. I thought you said you gave me a last one.
I did, but I'm a magician. There's more where that came from.
Mo, tricks up your sleeve.
Glad you can tell I ain't your ordinary old maid.
Certainly, certainly. Not too many maids walking around spouting off well-formed diatribes.
So what, you think us folk can't talk? But you think we don't?
Now, that's not what I said.
So you think you always gotta speak for us?
No, Camay, that's not what I said.
What you saying?
I just said most maids don't sound like professors.
Well, let me school you, you bougie Negro. I don't need no PhD to give you some education, understand? Divinity school, huh? You don't know who you're messing with.
Camay, I didn't mean to insult you. I just wanted to compliment you. You sang it real pretty.
Well, tell me, how are my oratorical skills? See, you ain't think I knew them words. How are my oratorical skills compared to...
Mine?
Sure.
I'm better. No, really. I mean, you sang it real pretty, but nobody can sing it like me. I've been doing this for years, darling. I'm gonna be doing it till the day I die.
But was it good?
For a woman, yes.
And if I was a man?
You'd be Malcolm X.
So you call him Malcolm X a sissy?
Now that's not what I said, Miss Camay.
You call it Malcolm X.
That's sissy. Not what I said.
I'ma tell it on. Malcolm! Marty, I think you a sissy!
Camay, come out from out that door, you're gonna get struck. Camay, you might need to leave blaspheming God like that. I don't like how you talk about God.
Wow. I was just trying to make you laugh. Bring a little laughter to your life. I like making folks laugh when you came. God knows you need it.
Well, I don't mind laughing. I like a good joke. You got to nowadays. I just don't like how you talk about God.
I'm sorry. God don't mind it. God ain't like sedated folk. God even like dirty jokes.
How you know what God like?
Cause I do. I know God like Malcolm X. And you would have liked him too. He didn't drink, smoke, cuss, or cheat on his wife.
And how are you privy to this information?
Like I said before, Negro talk strike faster than lightning. You ever meet him?
Once. But we never got a chance to really
talk.
Before he was
killed? That's a shame.
He was only 39. I'm 39.
He in heaven.
Is he?
Yeah, you'll see him there one day.
Camay, sometimes you talk a lot of nonsense.
Nonsense coming out of a pretty woman's mouth ain't nonsense at all. It's poetry.
No, I think that's what would your kind of folks say? Bullshit.
Oh. I like it when you get your feathers all ruffled. Get all blunt and look cute on you. But you will. In heaven.
So he in heaven, huh?
Why wouldn't he be?
Well, I don't know. He talked a lot of...
Truth?
He talked a lot of violence. He had a weakness for violent words. And if you speak by the sword, then you die by the sword.
You speak by love, die by hate. We all have our weaknesses, Preacher King. I'm sure you got your own. This ain't never let nobody know. For what it worth, I know God like you. The real you.
Do we?
She likes you.
She?
She told me she liked you, that if you was in heaven, you'd be her husband.
Oh, now, Camille, is that what God said?
Yeah.
So she in love with me?
She ain't in love. She in life. In life with us and Dr. King.
Camille, I think God ain't told you nothing. I think it's you who want me for your husband.
Me and God ain't got the same taste. I don't like no man with no smelly feet.
They do stink, don't they? Don't tell nobody.
Honey, your shoes off. I think the whole world know about you. Who would have thought Dr. King got some stanky feet? And you got holes in your socks, too.
You You know, Ken, man, you make it real easy.
Like what
easy? Easy for a man to forget about all of this.
That's what I'm here for.
What else are you here for?
What you trying to lynch yourself? Here, let me hear.
Thank you.
You welcome. You all right?
I can't breathe.
Well, I've been known to have that effect on you.
No, no. I can't breathe.
Oh my God, did I do something wrong?
I can't breathe.
I did something wrong.
I can't breathe.
Just look right here. Just look into my eyes. Michael, just breathe. I'ma get you through this. I'ma get you through this night.
Called me Michael.
I did?
Yes, you did. You called me Michael.
You scared me.
How would you know that?
Know what?
To call me that.
Call you what?
You know what the hell I'm talking about.
Calm down, Preacher King. I didn't mean to call you out your name.
But that is my name. My childhood name. How do you know my real name? My Christian name. Oh, you one of them.
I'm so sorry. I never wanted to do this. This is so hard for me to do.
What? Trying to come in here and tempt me?
No. I was sent to.
Tempt me? I don't want to hear it. Get out.
Hell, you was the one tempting me, getting me all off my job.
I said get out, you spook.
No.
I said get out.
I was only doing my job.
But y'all think y'all can... trap me? Record me with a woman? Well, you'll never catch me.
Preacher King.
Sending tapes to my wife, trying to break up my family, trying to break my spirit.
King, calm down.
But y'all trying to break me? Well, you'll never break me. You'll never break me again.
Preacher King, stop acting so paranoid. You're hurting me, Preacher King.
How much they pay you, you spook?
Let go, you're hurting me.
Who the hell is Ralph? Ralph! Ralph, I got a spook!
You're wrong.
Who the hell is Ralph? Hey! Hey! It's snowing. In April?
It snows sometime in spring here, isn't it?
It's still there. The snow is still there.
As it should be.
I'm just tired. Yeah, I'm tired. I'm tired. Got me seeing things that ain't there.
Oh, it's there.
No, it's not. Tell me it's not.
See, it's there.
You drugged me. You slipped some pills in my coffee. Slipped some hippie pills in my coffee. Got me seeing things that ain't there.
I just put some whiskey up in there to relax
you. You put some hippie pills in my coffee. Got me seeing snow. Snow? Snow? I can't go nowhere. I can't go nowhere.
Hey, calm down.
Help! Help!
Michael!
No, quit calling me that! Quit calling me that!
We need you to calm down. You're gonna give yourself a heart attack. You may be 39, but you have the heart of a 60-year-old man.
I can't. How do you know so much about me? Who the hell are you? Who the hell are you? Wow!
I know. Angel breath is my breath.
You're an angel?
In the flesh.
Well, where are your wings?
These will get me anywhere I need to go.
Oh!
Wow, you're an angel?
Yes, and I'm here to take you to the other side.
The other side? You mean I'm not dead?
No, not yet.
Good. So I was about to get mad if heaven looked like this. I'm not going to hell, am I?
No. Heaven is where we head.
Good. Do all angels look as good as you?
Yes.
Well, heaven must be mighty nice then. I wonder what the women in hell look like.
Honey, they fine. Why you think they in hell?
Cammy, you're really an angel?
I'm sorry I called you Michael. Not too many folk probably know that about you. God said that your Christian name kind of calms you. Ralph called you that too. Calms you down quick fast. Get a nice name. Name better than Cameo.
I changed it when my dad...
When your daddy did, when he was just 5. I done read your file. But I don't know why y'all want to be named after some Martin Luther, though. I met him in the cafeteria today, and he was kind of weird. Very.
Cammy, you're really an angel.
What else I got to do for you to believe me? Cry flowers?
But why God send you?
What you mean by that?
Why he?
She.
She send you? I mean, you're not what I was expecting.
Shit, you wasn't what I was expecting either, preacher gang.
Well, I'm not perfect.
That you ain't.
Hey, don't judge me, you cussing, fussing, drinking angel, you.
Well, God know what you like, huh?
Hey, now that ain't fair.
The truth ain't got to be fair, it's the truth.
But why you?
Believe you me, I ain't want this job. First day, bring over you, the king. I didn't want to do it. But God been getting these prayers from a little one named Bunny saying, please God, don't let my daddy die alone. When I heard it, just about broke my heart. I just had to come.
My baby girl spoke to you? My Bernice, my sweet Bernice. She spoke to you?
Her prayers are powerful. I can tell she's yawning. She's got a way with words, a gift. Sounded like she's gonna be a preacher one day. Now, I don't like cheering too much, but she's something.
My bunny, my baby girl, even she knows.
Yes, and I have to take you to the other side tomorrow. Now look, Preacher King, I know you're afraid. But
how you know I'm afraid?
Because you should be.
You want to talk about fair, KJ? had no fear. I felt it in my guts. Felt it in my toes. I felt it even when I stood in front of my own congregation in my own church. And there, beneath that old rugged cross, I quaked and shook with fear. Felt my insides churning, and I fought hard to keep them from leaping out of my mouth. You see, a Negro is not safe in a pulpit, not even a pulpit of his own making. Yes, Sunday mornings are the mornings when I'm most afraid, because in this country, a pulpit is a pedestal. And we all know in America that the tallest tree is felled first. Tall trees have more wood to burn, Kameh. We are the sacrifice.
You've been knowing I was coming, haven't you?
Yes. Oh, yes. I've dreamed of you. Rather had nightmares. And in my darkest hours, I've prayed for you with eyes wide open. Been so many death threats, some nights I just ask God, please just get it over with. Who knew death would be so beautiful? Almost make a man want to die.
You ain't afraid of me?
Fear has become my companion, my lover. I know the touch of fear better than I know the touch of my own wife. Fear, Kameh, is my best friend. She is the reason I wake up in the morning. Because I know that if I'm still afraid, I'm still alive.
Tomorrow in a time, you're gonna have to take my hand.
Tomorrow? But I'm not ready to die. I still have so much more work to do.
God, say it, time.
Time, no, I'm not ready. I still have more work to do. Why, America is going to hell.
Now, Preacher King, you're gonna have to put that.
A country who sends its boys to bathe little bitty brown babies in the blood of our greed is headed for a crossroads of conscience.
You hear what I said? You ain't gonna be able to finish that now.
And the consequence? Our young are flown home in star-strangled coffins, unwashable our hands, as we stand in heaven's gates, asking our God why he won't let us in. And why won't he let us in?
She let us in?
She? Because America is going to hell. Cast down like Lucifer into the pit to burn, baby, burn.
And I thought I was a radical one.
A tsunami of rage is rolling across the bottom of our seas. And our America, my sweet America, is surrounded by rising water waiting to drown. Pharaohs will be overthrown when that great wave of change casts them into the roiling waters. But the children of the Nile will rise. They will rise, my brethren. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I said, can I get an amen?
Amen.
See?
Amen.
Now, that'll make a good sermon now, won't it?
I'd sit in a pew for a few for that one.
So you agree with me? All right, then. Now I need to finish my sermon, and I need to be alone to finish my sermon, so you won't have to fly on away. A year ago, exactly a year ago, I stood in that pulpit at Riverside Church and shouted this war would be our own violent undoing. Freedom suicide. Well, I didn't get too many amens on that Sunday. But who is a man who does not speak his heart's conscience? He is not a man, but I am a man. If only they could see that love is the most radical force there is. But they won't listen. They've called me every name in the book but a child of God, even my own men. You're splitting the movement, Martin. You're splitting the movement. You can't focus on war and poverty and Negroes.
Well, ain't you just a civil rights leader? You can't talk about war, then this, then that.
What about it being hard on me? On my family? On Corey? On the movement? Has God thought about that?
God ain't the one you need to be mad at while you're up there yelling. God ain't the one you need to be blamed.
Well, who needs to be blamed?
It ain't who needs to be blamed, Preacher King. It's a what. It's not a who. It's a what. Evil is not under God's jurisdiction, but good. Good is.
Well, can't you just stop it? Can't you stop what's coming?
That ain't my job. God said I gotta get you ready to come on home.
But I'm not ready. We have so much more work to do. I got more sermons in me. More plans, more goals. Kemet, I want to do another march on Washington. Bigger, bolder, better.
Another dream of yours, huh?
But this time I want to make it a reality. It's the plan. It's called the Poor People's Campaign.
Poor People's Campaign? What that is? Better not be no other march. You and your marches.
Please, Kame, listen.
You and your marches, you got this line.
Please, listen!
I'm listening. Go on.
We've been organizing this campaign all year. All year! Imagine, Kame, on the Washington Mall, not just thousands, but millions.
Millions of niggas on the Washington Mall? Shit. You can't get off. Millions of niggas.
No, not just Negroes, but white folk, Chinese folk, Indian folk, Mexican folk, all banding together to shame this country. All kinds of poor people dragging their mule wagons across the Washington Mall. A rainbow of people chanting, stop the war in Vietnam, start the war on poverty.
How about make love, not poverty?
I like that one too. They can call me Kami King all they like, I don't care. But I refuse to allow poor people to be cast alongside of this Jericho road. That's why we had to come here to march peacefully. Memphis is only a dress rehearsal for the big one. Memphis is only the beginning.
Your men are carried on.
But I'm the leader of the movement, the head of the body.
Well, the body just gonna have to grow another head. Because Memphis is the end of the road for you.
End of the road? But can't you just ask God?
Honey, I can't do no kind of special favors.
But look, just till the end of the month, till I see this thing through now, just till April 29th.
And what if she lets you? You're just gonna keep on saying one more day, one more month, one more this, one more that.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you will. I know you, Preacher King.
But I've got so much more work to do.
What about your men's? Can't they see it through?
They don't dream the same dreams I do, Kame. They think I'm crazy to dream this big, and maybe I am a little crazy. But how can we fight a war in Vietnam and not fight the war against Negroes in our own streets? How can we try to send a man to the moon and not feed starving children in Mississippi? It's just so much more work I gotta do. So much more I just have not accomplished. I still got so much more work to do.
Well, it ain't all about you. Gosh, you men are so selfish. I always think it's about them. Huh? But let me tell you something, Preacher King, let me tell you. Like most men, you ain't gonna be able to finish what you started.
My house has been bombed. I have been pelted with rocks. My arm twisted behind my back. My face shoved into a ground of gravel I have been kicked at, spit at, pummeled and abused, looked at with the deepest of scorn. I have been stabbed in my chest, and I walked away alive. Alive. If I would have sneezed, I would have died.
Well, I'm glad you ain't have a cold that day.
Look at the life I've lived. You gonna tell me I ain't got favor with God? That I ain't jumped over every hurdle in this race?
Well, sometimes you clear the hurdles, and sometimes you ain't. Remember, Albany, you done brought us mighty far, but you're a man. You're just a man, baby. You're not God. Though some folks say you got mighty close, you know. Sometimes you failed.
Like that boy. That boy they shot, Larry Payne.
Now that wasn't your fault. Police killed that boy, not you.
So this motel room will become my tomb? I've survived so much.
Honey, I read all about your trials and tribulations. I was seeing your blessings file. It's bigger than your FBI file, and that's bigger than the Bible. I know it may be hard for you to leave this life, your family and all your plans, but you're gonna have to pass off that baton, little man. You in a relay race. Albeit the fastest runner we'd have never seen, but you about burn out, superstar. You gonna need to pass off that baton.
Now I know I've dropped the baton so many times over this race, but I promise I won't do it again. Tell her.
Tell her?
Yes, tell her. I promise I won't do it again. I will not drop this baton anymore. Tell her. She needs to let me stay. Ask her for me.
Well, you know, you ain't supposed to question God. That's the rule. You know that.
There ain't no rules for no angel like you.
Shit, God got rules. I had to read the whole Bible today.
Please, Cammie.
Dr. Kane.
Please, Cammie!
Well, what you gonna give me?
A kiss from the Kane.
You want no kiss from you? You ain't brushed your teeth today.
Please, Cammie.
Dr. Kane.
Please!
You're lucky I remember this. It's just my first day.
I know.
Let me talk to her. I want to talk to your supervisor.
I'm trying to butter her up first.
Butter her up? Let me talk to her.
Hold on a minute,
but he's stubborn and quite convincing. I'm sure he got away with words.
I know. You tell me.
Oh, you want to talk to him? Well, good, because he want to talk to you.
Yes, Michael, to you. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Is she
black?
God, ma'am, you don't sound like I thought you'd sound. No. Pardon me. Actually, you sound a lot like my grandma. Well, yes, I did mean that as a compliment. I loved her dearly, but I love you more, though. God, now, Cam A told me you might be busy tonight, and I don't... Oh, you have time for me. For one of your favorites. God, you sound hoarse. You all right? Oh, you tired? Well, I imagine it is tiring being everywhere all at the same time. Now, God, I don't want to trouble you. I just want to ask you something. You see, I've always listened to you. I've always honored your word, lived by your word, for the most part. But God, please don't strike me down for asking this, but God, I want to live. I got so many plans in my head and in my heart for my people. And my people, they need me. They need me, and I need to see them to the promised land. Now, I know that's not what I said at the church tonight. But I wasn't lying exactly. I just didn't know she was coming so soon. But God, I meant every word I said at that church tonight. Dead honest. No pun intended. But God, I just want to see my people there. The tide is turning. The war has become the order of the day, and I must convince them to be vigilant. We've come too far to turn back now. No, God, please listen. Well, who else is better fit for the job? I mean, who's gonna take my place? Jesse! I just thought Ralph would make a better... No. I have not turned vain. On the contrary, God, I'm but a servant of you. Yes, God, ma'am, I've been a servant of you all my life. Now, I know there were times when I wasn't up for the challenge, but even then I knew that was part and parcel for the course. So I stayed on route and I served your word. I honored your word, Lord. Lord, let me not die a man who does not get to hug his children one more time. Let me not die a man who does not get to make love to his wife one last time. Lord, let me not be a man who dies afraid and alone. Well, why'd you pick me then, huh? I mean, no disrespect, but if you didn't know what I could do and what my talents were, then, well, you've got some nerve. dragging me here to this moldy motel room in Memphis to die? Huh? Of all places. Yes, I am angry. I am. Many a nights I've held my tongue when it comes to you, but not tonight. Not tonight. You, God, you said I'd be safe. Safe in your arms. You said you'd protect me all this time. All this time you glued a pair of wings to my back. And now that I've flown too close to the sun, I'm falling into an ocean of death. God, how dare you take me now? God, please. Please, God. God? Ma'am? God?
What'd she say?
I think she hung up on me.
It could have been a drop call.
A drop call? Is this angel talk you speak? How does one drop a call?
You act like I'm speaking in tongues.
Well, you speak of things I know nothing about.
Yes, I speak of the future.
The future?
You would have got me in trouble.
God gonna tear my hide from brown to barbecue.
How'd I get you in trouble?
I can't just call her for you. You're gonna make me lose my wings.
Well, good. You deserve to lose them, luring men to their deaths like this. I can't believe God hung up on me.
Well, I'd have hung up on you too, yelling like that.
God done forsook her servant. She hung up on me.
She ain't forsaken either. She just didn't want to hear your shit. She's got it right. She is God, you know.
Well, I am Dr. King, you know.
Don't mock me, man.
You know.
I do not sound like that.
At least you don't say, you dig, like a Black Panther party angel.
Oh?
Kameh, God gonna get you for beating up on one of her favorites like this.
Can't believe you said to come get you with your crazy ass.
Uh-huh.
You think you're so funny?
Yeah, what now? Hit me now if you think you're bad.
Ow!
That's what you get for battling the king of pillow fighting. Where's that rule?
In the Bible.
Where?
Ezekiel, you fool!
No.
Stop it!
I bet you'll tickle you.
Don't tickle me.
Why?
Because I'm a pee on you.
Angels don't pee.
Yes, they do. Try me. That's in the Bible, too.
No, it's not.
Watch out. My piss gonna burn you.
I don't believe you. Who thought death would be so beautiful?
Sometimes. Tonight a good night. I remember my rouge.
Kameh?
Yeah, Dr. King.
Just hold me.
Leave it all out. Give it all to me. I'll take it all.
I prayed this all would stop.
And
that it would all just go away. I only wanted to be a minister in my church. That was enough.
But when you make a cause, you must heed the call.
I just wanted to be a minister in my small church. That was enough.
But God had bigger plans for you.
Why me?
Why not?
Because I'm just a man. I'm a man. I know that now, I know. And I think it's time for me to go on home. Help me pack my things.
You won't be needing that. You won't be needing that at all. Heaven's got all you need.
But I need to leave my men some instructions, some notes for them.
They'll take care of
you. They need to know what to do when I'm gone.
They'll know what to do. You've taught them well.
Well, my wife. I need to talk to my wife. pick up. Corey, pick up. Corey, 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 pick up. I always bought her flowers when I went away. Always with the mind that they would last just long enough until I got back home. Sometimes they did, most times they didn't. I could never make amends. I picked a beautiful flower called absence. And I picked it to stand in for those passing pockets of time to exist just as I had existed for her. Last week, when I was home, I passed by the shop and I saw the most perfect flowers, radiant red carnations. I walked into that shop. And you know what I found out, Kame? Those flowers weren't real. My eyes had fooled me. I bought those flowers, and they arrived just yesterday morning before I boarded the plane to go to Memphis. She came to me with a twinkle in her eye, and she said, "Why, Martin? You never buy me these artificial things." I just smiled. And I said, "Today is different. Today."
You knew she'd need a flower that could last forever.
If only I could tell them how sorry I am. If only I could have been there with them. I miss birthdays. I miss holidays.
You did what you had to do. We needed you. The world needed you.
So many times I wanted to quit. I wanted to give up the ghost.
But you didn't. You prevailed.
I don't want to be a martyr.
How for the man that can get more done dead than alive? Tomorrow, you'll be a man-made martyr. No better yet, a saint.
Don't call me that. I'm not deserving of the title. I'm a sinner, not a saint. Don't call me that.
So what do you think I am?
You must have pleased God with the way you lived your life.
I didn't.
I thought all angels were perfect.
You perfect?
No.
Then why should I be? Honey, I've robbed, I've lied, I've cheated, I've failed, I've cussed. But what I'm ashamed of most is I've hated. Hated myself. Sacrificed my flesh so that others might feel whole again. Thought it was my duty, all I had to offer this world. What else a poor black woman and mule of the world here for? Last night in the back of an alley, I breathed my last breath. A man clasped his hand like a necklace around my throat, and I stared into his big blue eyes as my breath got ragged and raw. I saw the hell this old world had put him through. Tommy saw his father hang a man. Tommy saw his mother raped. I saw the hell this old world had put him through, and I still couldn't forgive. I hated him for stealing my breath. And when I passed on to the other side, and I saw God. She is more gorgeous than me. She the color of midnight. Her eyes are brighter than the stars, and her hair. Just you wait till you see her hair. God stood before me with this look on her face, and I just know she was so disappointed in me. I was just a-crying and weeping at her feet, begging her not to throw me down. All that sinning, all that grime on my soul. All that hatred in my heart. Then I looked up and I saw that she was smiling down at me. She opened her mouth and silence came out, but I heard her loud and clear. I have a special task for you, and if you complete it, all your sins will be washed away.
I hope my father, that's all my task for you. What could little old me give a big old you? I thought you was gonna be perfect, right? You ain't. But then you are.
You have the biggest heart I've ever known. You have the strength to love those who could never love you back. If I had just a small fraction of the love that you have for this world, then maybe, just maybe, I can become half the angel that you are.
Will I die at the hands of a white man too?
Yes. Speak by love, die by hate.
Where will it be?
On the balcony, just right there.
How?
Surrounded by those who love you.
Will you be there to clean up the mess?
It would be an honor, Preacher Kane.
Will there be others after me to carry on the baton?
Many. Many are carrying on, but there'll never be another you. You're a once-in-a-lifetime affair.
Is the future as beautiful as you?
Yes, and it's as ugly as me, too.
Well, I want to see it.
I don't know if you can take it. It just might break your heart.
My heart already weary, Kame. But I want to see it before I die.
But I thought you didn't already see the promised land.
I've seen it in my dreams. But I want to see it with my own eyes, my own eyes. That way, if you let me see it, I can die a happy man tomorrow, and I'll gladly go into your arms. But let me see these dreams that I'll never see.
I'll let you see. But when you're called, you have to come. I have to take you home tomorrow.
But what time shall I meet you?
6:01 p.m.
Will it hurt?
You won't feel the hurt, but the world will.
You promise?
Promise. You ready? Let's take it to the mountaintop. The Prince of Peace shot. His blood stains the concrete outside room 306. A worker wipes away the blood, but not before Jesse baptizes his hands on the balcony. The baton passes on. Memphis burning, DC burning, cities burning, Vietnam burning, coffins coming home. Another Kennedy killed, the baton passes on. Mayan Rustin, Stonewall Rides, Andrew Young, Julian Bond, Bob Marley, Redemption Songs, Angela Davis, Assata Shakur, Afro Picks, Black Raised Fists, Olympics, the baton passes on. White children, black children, Crayola colored children together in a cafeteria. Roots, the Jeffersons, Cindy Pontier, Superfly, Isaac Hayes, James Brown, I'm black and I'm proud. Jessica President, I am somebody. Crips, Bloods, Blue, Red, White, Crack, Smack, Marion Barry, Tracks, AIDS, Reagan wins again. Burning Walls, Apartheid Falls, Robben Island sets Mandela free. Rodney King screams, can't we all just get along? And the baton passes on. No peace in the Middle East. Ruby Dee, you sure is ugly. Spike Lee, Rwanda reads. Bill Clinton, nigga please. Skinheads, The Cosby Show. Baby Mama, Soul Train, Montel, Don't Ask, Don't Tell. Run DMC, BET, MTV, Walk This Way. And the baton passes on. and on to the break of dawn for the American song, we shall overcome. A white bronco flees into the night. If it doesn't fit, you must acquit. James Byrne, Columbine, Ron Brown, Colin Powell, Clarence Thomas, Tupac, Oprah, Biggie, Crack Corners from Crenshaw to MLK Boulevard. Osama bin Laden, Saddam Hussein, Judith Bush, Condi Rice, Tyler Saw, World Turns Gray, September 11, one bright morning day. Katrina, Katrina, America is apple pie. Drove the Chevy to the levee, but the levee was drowned. The Superdome, drive-bys, McDonald's, diabetes, NBA, Iraq, high-paid slaves, the children of the now, a nuclear 8 mile, black picket fences in Genesis 6, American flags and black presidents. The baton passes on. The baton passes on. The baton passes on. The baton passes on.
What is this vision I see before me? Could it be my wildest dream? There it is. There it is. A land where hunger is no more. Where poverty is no more. Where richness is no more. War is no more. Color no more. Destruction no more. Only love. Fierce, radical love. The promised land here on earth. I accept. May never walk that blessed garden over yonder, that lush land on the far side of the moon. It is so. Well, nobody said it was going to be easy. And nobody said it would happen in an instant. Everybody said we'd never get there. But nobody thought we'd make it this far. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I said, can I get an amen?
Amen.
You have wandered the deserts, the flaming sands burning your feet, but you're standing on the edge of Canaan, on a mountaintop made of the dreams of men and women who have paid the ultimate price with their lives. Children of the now, you must rise. For you can no longer walk weary through this world with willing backs. Your time is now, I tell you now. The baton may have been dropped, but anyone can pick it back up again. I don't know where in this race we are, but I say, pick up that baton and pass it along. For you are the climbers, the new carriers of the cross, and I beg you, I implore you, don't get in and toss it off. For on this here mountaintop, there's beauty to behold, the promised land, your promised land, in red, black, and white, blue, brown, and gold. Canaan is calling. She's calling for you to come. The promised land is so close and yet so far. So close and yet so far. So close and yet so
time.